Bore, be still, and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. Psalms 46:10. Imagine a scenario where everything around you seems to be falling apart, and worries pile up like a storm about to break. It is in these moments of chaos that we are called to do something counterintuitive. To be still, God invites us to stop, to stand still, and to know that He is God. He asks us to let go of control, to surrender all our battles to Him, and to trust in His power. Have you ever felt this way, caught in the turmoil of life, trying to find a solution on your own? God is ready to act, but first, He needs you to be still and trust Him. Often, we find ourselves in situations that are beyond our control, circumstances where we have tried everything, yet nothing seems to change. In such moments, anxiety and worry can easily take over us, and it's natural to want to act and solve everything ourselves. However, the Bible invites us to a different path, a path of trust and stillness. God calls us to stand still and watch His hand work on our behalf. One passage that exemplifies this attitude of trust is Exodus 14:14, where Moses comes standing before the Red Sea with the Egyptian army approaching, told the people of Israel, "The Lord will fight for you. You need only to be still." Imagine the panic the people felt as they saw the sea in front of them and their enemies behind, ready to attack. In such a desperate situation, God's command was simple: "Be still, trust in me, and see what I will do." God was about to perform a miracle, parting the sea and providing a safe path for His people. This story teaches us that even when everything seems hopeless, God is capable of acting in a supernatural way, and often He asks us to simply wait and trust. Another powerful example can be found in the life of King Jehoshaphat. In 2 Chronicles 20, Jehoshaphat faced a great threat as several armies united against him. Feeling powerless in the face of danger, he sought the Lord and declared a fast throughout Judah. The people gathered to seek God, and he responded through the prophet, "Do not be afraid or discouraged because of this vast army, for the battle is not yours, but God's." 2 Chronicles 20:15. God instructed Jehoshaphat not to fight, but to position himself and watch the salvation he would bring. The next day, as Jehoshaphat and the people praised God, the Lord caused confusion among their enemies, and they defeated one another. Jehoshaphat and his people didn't need to raise a sword, they only needed to trust and witness God at work. These biblical stories remind us that when we face battles and challenges, we don't have to fight alone or rely solely on our own strength. God calls us to trust in Him, to stand still, and to observe how He resolves what seems impossible to us. This doesn't mean we should be passive or indifferent. Rather, we should place our worries and problems in God's hands and trust in His power and wisdom. When we quiet ourselves before Him and put our faith into action, we create space for God to work powerfully and unexpectedly in our lives. Today, God is inviting you to trust in Him, to rest in His presence, and to watch how He can mend what is broken. Whatever situation you are facing, remember that God is faithful and has control over all things. You don't have to carry this burden alone. God is with you, and He is capable of transforming even the most difficult situations into a testament of His glory and power. Let's together surrender our concerns to the Lord, standing firm and trusting that He will act. Often, we are driven to act impulsively when confronted with problems. It's natural to want to resolve things as quickly as possible, but this can lead us to make hasty decisions. The Bible teaches us, however, the importance of being patient and trusting God to act at the right time. The story of Sarah and Abraham exemplifies how a lack of patience can bring complications. God had promised Abraham that he would be the father of a great nation, but Sarah and Abraham felt that the promise was taking too long to be fulfilled. In Genesis 16, Sarah, feeling impatient, suggested that Abraham have a child with her servant Hagar. This hasty decision brought conflict and sorrow to the family. However, God was faithful to his promise, and in due time, Sarah gave birth to Isaac, the child of promise. This teaches us that even when the answer seems delayed, we should wait and trust that God will fulfill his promises. When we quiet ourselves and let God act, he brings the right solution at the right time. Another challenge many face is dealing with situations of conflict and opposition. When we are attacked or wronged, our natural reaction is to want to defend ourselves or retaliate. However, the Bible shows us a different way to handle these situations by entrusting them to God and allowing him to fight our battles. In 1 Samuel 24, we find David being pursued by King Saul, who wanted to kill him. David had the opportunity to take revenge when he found Saul in a cave, but he chose not to lift a hand against the Lord's anointed. He told his men, "May the Lord keep me from doing such a thing to my master, the Lord's anointed, or lifting my hand against him, for he is the anointed of the Lord." David decided to trust that God would be his defender and take care of the situation. Later, God honored this attitude, and David was elevated to the throne of Israel without shedding innocent blood. When we face opposition, God calls us to trust in him and let him fight for us. Our task is to stand firm and allow God to vindicate us in his timing. There are moments when we feel surrounded by impossible circumstances, when we see no way out or solution in sight. It could be a financial crisis, a difficult medical diagnosis, or a complicated family situation. In such times, our faith is tested and we may feel powerless. The Bible gives us the example of Joshua and the people of Israel before the walls of Jericho. In Joshua 6, God gave specific instructions for the people to march around the city for 7 days, and on the seventh day, they were to shout loudly. The walls of Jericho were impenetrable, but God did not ask the people to fight with their own strength. He asked them to trust in him and follow his instructions. When they obeyed and trusted, the walls came crashing down. This teaches us that even when everything seems impossible, God is capable of breaking down barriers. Sometimes, all we need to do is trust and obey his voice, even when we don't understand how he will act. We also face moments when we feel that we have done everything we could, yet still don't see results. This feeling of helplessness can lead us to discouragement and frustration. However, God invites us to be patient and trust that he is working behind the scenes. The story of Martha and Mary when they lost their brother Lazarus is a perfect example of waiting on God. In John 11, Lazarus was sick, and the sisters sent for Jesus. However, Jesus deliberately waited 2 days before going to them. When he arrived, Lazarus had already been dead and buried for 4 days. Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died." But Jesus replied that if they believed, they would see the glory of God. Jesus then performed an incredible miracle, raising Lazarus from the dead. Sometimes, God waits until a situation seems hopeless so that he can demonstrate his power in an even more glorious way. When we face situations that seem to have come to an end, we are called to trust that God has the power to bring life and renewal even when everything appears lost. Now, let us prepare for prayer. This is the moment to set aside the worries and pressures we carry, surrendering them to the Lord. When we quiet ourselves and allow God to take control, we make room for him to act on our behalf. Let's draw near to him now, ready to hand over our struggles and rest in the assurance that he is faithful to mend what is broken and bring peace to our souls. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, We gather before you at this moment with humble hearts, filled with expectation. We know that you are the God who sees every detail of our lives, who knows our struggles, fears, and worries. We come before you today with situations that seem beyond our control, problems that weigh heavily on us and lead us to a state of anxiety and unrest. But at this hour, we want to obey your call to be still and trust. We want to surrender to you everything that has left us unsettled, certain that you are capable of mending every broken part. Lord, sometimes we are quick to act and slow to trust. We try to solve things on our own, relying on our own strength and abilities, but often we fail. Today, we want to acknowledge that there are battles only you can win. We want to learn from the words you spoke through Moses to the people of Israel. The Lord will fight for you. You need only to be still. Exodus 14:14. We stand before our Red Sea, feeling surrounded on all sides. But just as you parted the sea and made a way where there was none, we know you can do the same for us. Help us to rest in your promise that you will fight for us. Give us the faith to be still, to not rush, but to wait for your divine intervention. Father, we also want to bring before you those situations of conflict and opposition that we face. Sometimes we are misunderstood, attacked, or treated unfairly, and our tendency is to defend ourselves, argue, or even retaliate. But today, we remember David, who chose not to lift a hand against Saul, even when he had the chance. He decided to trust that you were his defender and that you would take care of everything. We want to learn to do the same. We want to hand over to you every person and every situation that has caused us pain or injustice. We ask that you intervene and be our judge, bringing justice and vindication in your time and in your way. Help us to be peacemakers, to act with love, and to let your mighty hand be our defense. Lord, there are areas in our lives where we face obstacles and barriers that seem insurmountable. It could be a financial problem, an illness, or a broken relationship. It feels like we've tried everything and still can't see a solution. But today, we want to look to you and declare that you are the God of the impossible. Just as Joshua and the people of Israel saw the walls of Jericho fall, we believe that you can bring down any barrier that stands before us. Help us to trust in your instructions and to walk in obedience to your voice, even when we don't understand how you are going to act. We know that you can do what none of us can. We want to see your power at work and witness your miracles in our lives. Father, we also remember moments when it seems like we've done everything we could, and yet we still don't see results. This leads us to discouragement and a sense of helplessness. But today, we choose to trust that you have a purpose in every situation. Just as Martha and Mary thought it was too late for Lazarus, but Jesus showed that it's never too late for your power, we want to believe that you can resurrect dreams, bring life where there is death, and restore hope where there is despair. Help us to wait patiently and trust that you are working even when we can't see it. We want to entrust each situation to you and rest in the assurance that you are faithful to fulfill your purposes in us. As we pray, we also want to thank you. Thank you for reminding us that we are not alone. Thank you for being the God who fights for us, who defends us, who breaks down barriers, and who brings life to what is dead. Today, we have chosen to be still and observe how the Lord will act in our lives. We have chosen to trust in your power, in your wisdom, and in your perfect will. Help us to live this day with a calm heart, assured that you are already working in every detail. May your peace, which surpasses all understanding, guard our hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray and entrust everything into your hands. Amen. If you were blessed by this prayer, please type the word Amen in the comments section below. I declare that all the blessings of this prayer are now upon you, in Jesus' name. You can help us reach more people and spread the gospel by sharing this video with a friend or family member and clicking the like button. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel, Our Father, for more videos that will bless your heart and strengthen your spirit. We deeply appreciate all your support. You are blessed to be a blessing. Feel free to leave your prayer requests in the comments section so that we can present them before God, asking for His blessings and victory, and so that other believers on YouTube and around the world can join us in prayer for you. Stand firm in faith with us as we pray. Our team wants to express gratitude to everyone who has helped sustain our ministry. Your generosity allows us to continue creating and sharing content that strengthens and inspires faith. Repeat after me with great faith: I have the right to be happy. If you believe in this statement, write that phrase in the comments with strong faith. To God be all the glory. May the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.